Awesome.
All right, we're gonna call the executive committee order.
I make a motion to adopt the agenda as intended on the paper.
Second.
Question? Favor?
Aye.
Curious? How about our minutes for September 19th? Motion to approve.
Second.
Any discussion on the minutes? All those in favor?
Aye.
Curious? Are there any public comments?
We might have one on for public comment, have a Charles Benz, allow him to talk if he's here for public comment.
We don't do virtual public comments anymore.
Oh, we do not? Okay, then. Then no, we don't.
Okay, any supervisors here or not, either those committee members? Lots of recommendations on proposed updates to the Polk County Board of Supervisors vote of ethics.
So, you wanted in something regarding closed session, so I drafted some language to consider. What I haven't drafted is any, like, recommended punishment for a violation. But this would make it clear the information obtained in a closed session needs to remain in a closed session. And that somebody who a seated board member or member of a committee who has a conflict would excuse themselves from the closed session, because right now there is no provision to exclude someone who has a conflict. Now, determining whether somebody has a conflict, I put language in here that it would be the chair of whatever committee is dealing with the closed session and the court counsel making the decision. But if the chair is the one who has a potential conflict, it would go to the vice chair of that committee or board.
Can I ask you a question? So it says shall not participate, but can they remain in the room, or do we have them leave?
No, my intention was that they would not hear the information.
They wouldn't even hear the information. Right. So we should maybe clarify that they sure can't even be there.
Yeah.
I would think, because it just says they can't participate, they might still sit here and listen. You know, it still falls well with what happened.
Excuse themselves from the.
Yeah. If that makes sense, because otherwise they're going to hear it anyway. Okay, nothing. They just can't talk. They'll talk.
Maybe
that's what
we're trying
to do.
Can I ask a question, Liam? How do we get, like, if we were to go up screen again, then how do we get the point of someone? Is it all self-reporting?
It would have to be self-reporting, which is the same way it is now.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I'm thinking of a situation where you have a clear and direct conflict. You know, we're negotiating with, you know, bidding on something, and that person is a principal of the company. You know, there would be some clear, then there would be some where somebody is implying that there might be a conflict, and that's where the chair and the corporate counsel would make a decision on that basis.
Yeah. If I
would have
done something for the company, whole session for the bid or something. So get it as high as I can. No, I mean,
I'll shoot on the other
foot. But I mean, that's kind of what you're
looking at. Yeah. Without any penalties for disclosing closed session, I mean, you remind everyone over and over and over again not to disclose it. Yet if they do, there is no penalty. Why would we have any?
So if you look at the current language in your rules of ethics, there would be sort of the public shaming is really the only teeth. You know, having the ethics committee, this committee, talk about it, make a decision, make a determination, and then publicly say this person violated their ethical obligations to the county board or committee. You can't do anything like they need to forego their per diem, because then you'd be modifying their compensation in the year that that they have it. You, if you wanted to address compensation and have there be some type of financial penalty by way of per diem, you could only make that effective after the next county board is elected and seated, because then you'd be setting your compensation for your future board with this caveat that you would lose it if there were a violation. Yeah.
So there's no like $2,500 or something that we could put in there instead.
I think the only way you can,
because the public shame us, that's if I got 10 grand extra, I can shame me all you want.
So I don't think it could be a fine. I think it would have to be a reduction in the per diem or compensation of board members.
So how does the public shaming?
That's what I think.
How does that how does the mechanics of that work? So say somebody in a closed session, they spoke out of turn somewhere else. How does that come back?
I think you only use it at election time.
So it's not something that we've had in time.
Yeah. Well, again, it would come back to this committee as the ethics committee. The ethics committee, if they determined that yes, there was a violation, they would probably have some type of public statement that would go into the media. And again, there's no real team there.
Well, then would it come back to this committee because chair requested it come back? How would it come back here?
It would come back to this committee based upon the rules of order. So that if somebody alleged a violation of the ethics code, it would come to this committee to determine whether there was a violation of the ethics code, because that's what it says in your rules of order. So I, like the chair of this committee couldn't say, well, I'm not putting that on, you know, if one board member is saying another board member has violated the board of ethics.
Complaint.
Yeah.
So this could be anybody, could be someone in the public also.
Yeah, no,
you could do a complaint though.
Yes.
And then we would look into it against somebody on the board.
Yes. And
okay, now this is just people on the board, not employees, anybody else?
It would include citizen members on appointed boards like Health and Human Services or the
ad hoc committee.
Yeah.
It'd have to be available for a,
right.
So that it qualified for that.
Right.
That could be.
It would not be an employee, though. Employee has their own, I mean, that would be a disciplinary issue, not a public ethics complaint.
And if an employee was in, could be in our closed session and violated later, they would be subject to their own discipline. They got a program.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at theirs and see if we can follow that.
Well, I mean, depending upon how we reach it, you could terminate them.
The other question is that it's board members or anyone appointed to a committee.
Anyone
in. So we should probably have that in there too.
That would, sure.
Instead of just any board member, it should be board member ad hoc committees.
Well, they are covered under the rules of who's allowed in a closed session.
Yeah,
right.
But
I mean,
you should define it a little better.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Is just anybody that qualifies for a closed session.
Yeah, so it would be any committee, any of these committees.
Yes,
there's a bunch of committees that are included.
Yep, I added or citizen appointed member.
Okay, so Malia, are you going to include the penalties to be a public shaming?
No, that is just by the nature of your current ethics code.
So the public shaming might be.
It's not the word, I mean, it's not in the ethics
right.
code, but it would be.
You could be censured.
You could do a censure, but that would be the full county board. So, and again, that's
no tar and feathers.
All that depends on the county board.
Not allowing them to participate.
No, censure is the board voting and saying you did a bad thing. We all think so. Again, it's public shaming.
Better public shaming.
All censure is. A statement that the full county board believes this member acted in violation of the ethics.
Okay, that kind of first.
All right, anything else? Anybody else want to comment on this?
We want to say a bunch of things as public venture.
I mean, that would be, again, up to the ethics committee, this committee making a recommendation to the Polk County Board based upon whatever the nature of the violation.
Well, we'll be making this recommendation to include this to the Polk County Board.
If you would like to, then we would, I would draft a resolution to modify your ethics committee.
And then at that time, I'm sure it would come out what the penalty is going to be.
Or we'd have to have something to say what it could, that we could do now and then.
Right.
If we had to rewrite it for the next year, it would be, you'd lose per diem for two meetings or one or something. Sure. I mean, to put a little teeth in it or at least one.
Yeah, that's right. What I was trying to think. We just do a list of options, per diems and adventure.
So is this coming back to this committee or are you going to write a resolution?
If you want me to write a resolution, I will do that and bring it back.
Oh, we want?
Yes.
Yeah, gotta get started. Yeah.
Don't worry about the penalties eventually.
All right. How about our statistical information platform?
Mind if I do that?
No.
I apologize for the minuscule print here in advance.
You always got something to apologize.
Well, you're not talking to my wife, sir.
I don't know.
Guess, at our last meeting, he had all kinds of extra money, so it was good.
Yeah, right.
Everybody was above board.
Okay, so what are we looking at? This is, I think, the third time we've discussed this, and it the thought springs out of what we've been doing with CJCC data, presenting it to the board each month. And the question came up whether, in addition to looking at information that was around public safety, crime, and CJCC, we might use that agenda item that's on the, you know, the board agenda each month differently. So this is just one proposal. And you'll see, Mo, that your name's on there somewhere in here, hard to read. But the idea would be, if you're looking at far left column next to the dates, then we essentially have, it's like a editorial account that each of the committees of the board would have on a monthly, three times a year, the opportunity to hear information that was relevant to the committee and then bring it up to the board level. So if you think about it, that's sort of what's happened with the CJCC and Public Safety Public Works. There's been information that's presented at the committee meeting, and then it's just been, we've done it every month. And so the question that we're putting before you today is, would you like to move to something like this, where in addition to just hearing public safety, public works items, and we could also include Mo and the sheriff in that, but then we cycle through to ES and general government and HHS. So in advance of any discussion here, I checked off with our IT director, Scott Good, who manages our data analyst, Abigail Paulson, and he fully endorses this idea. And he says, we're already working on some data displays for HHS. I don't want to get out in front of Tanya. But she may have things that are coming out of that effort that she want to share with HHS and would be relevant to the broader board. You know, that Bob has talked about, you know, at least once a year from an ES perspective, talking about what's going on with building permits. That's kind of an early indicator of where construction is going to be, which is great because then we learn how much money we're going to get in at new construction. So this is a proposal. It's marked draft. If you're enthusiastic about it, I'll drop it to the other directors with Vince at our directors meeting. I suppose we could even have some room for corporate counsel. But the idea would just be to open up that agenda item, use it a little bit more broadly, get stuff going at the committee level, and then sort of hoist it up to the board level. That's the idea in a nutshell.
What you're saying is that I can understand that with CJCC because presentations will be every 3 months to the sheriff.
Well, okay, I'll give you. Can
I, just yeah. things that he's preparing to tell us in 3 months that the accumulation of information that not repetitious, but it comes occasionally. But we're bound to have stuff in the middle of these 3 month period.
Of course, and we wouldn't want to limit his ability to bring that forward to the committee to the board. I'll just give you an idea from my own thought. So, you know, we're constantly looking at where we are with workforce. How many open positions do we have?
Right.
How long does it take to fill vacancies? What's going on with the job market? So, as an example, you know, we could come to the November board meeting and present some information like that graphically and give just a brief presentation on where we are with, you know, with our workforce. And then, you know, maybe I've got us not doing it until July, and we do it again. So twice a year, we would give that update from HR. We wouldn't want to be, we're not trying to waste the board's time. This is really if you think the committees would benefit from this kind of cycle, and the board itself sort of educationally would benefit from this kind of cycle. There's a lot of things to work out. You know, the directors most seeing this for the first time. You may want to have some time to think about, you know, could you present on highways or facilities a couple of times a year? First at public safety, public, you do it all the time at public safety, public works, but then bring it up to the board level. Would this make any sense? Could be a terrible idea, we want it out.
Great idea. There's been many times when you've had HHS presentations or data that Tanya presented us, like, or a committee member will ask something about, well, right now we're in the topic of unhoused. Where's the housing stuff at? And I've always said, yeah, it'd be nice for the full board, they would find this interesting. So I think condensing that into your data presentation is great as opposed to dragging in a whole person to do a presentation. I have always liked this idea. Great idea. Rotate through all the departments.
Well, the division, I think the divisions hopefully like it, yeah. You know, so they know what they're doing instead of like end of the year, we get such a huge list, it gets too long.
Yeah, right.
You know, we get end of year what you did for a whole year, maybe when you break it into thirds, it won't be quite as overpowering. Run meetings so long and stuff. So
an update.
Yeah, some updates. That everybody hears it.
Anything that comes up, example being roads, or you know, we get a presentation every month about County Road M. Now it's 2 miles closer to the project finish. Anything of a significance would be caught at a committee meeting, and that could be taken out of the 3 month project proposal and explained if it's significant. So this can be adjusted on a monthly basis, also by committee presentation. Committee, they're going to get it anyway. But I think it's a good idea. Yeah, anything cut down the time on a county board meeting is good.
Well, it could be a two-way, because maybe we hear something from a question from a fellow board, it changes what we sort of look at it at the back in our committees.
Yeah. Right.
This is to see if a committee's doing its job.
That's number one.
They're not doing anything. Well, no.
I would see like the quarterly or the third ones, maybe just seeing this would be more of the big picture. You know, how many, what is our overall PASER rating the last 5 years? Is it trending up? Is it trending down? What are our costs per mile going? Is it going up? Is it going down? Where we need to invest? Are we getting that? Are we maintaining our system, or is our system slowly degrading? So more of the big picture, 5 year. Plans out, not specific. We're paving D this month.
So this is something that does not require anything from you. We can implement this and start rolling it out.
He's not. Are you going to continue to
tweak this a little bit, or?
So we have frequent directors meetings. I think the next step is to have the directors review this and ask if they have the content, you know, can they stay on a schedule like this? And would it be useful for them and useful to you all? We haven't had that conversation yet, but I would think that would be the next step.
We just want to go ahead approval, so to speak, verbal.
Yeah, I think it's one of those where I get a consensus that, hey, this is a good idea,
yeah.
Rather than having the CJCC every month saying, okay, now this month we had 19 arrests. It's going to be a more in-depth analysis of what's happening over time. And it's not just CJCC. We do that every 3 months, 4 months. But we'll also have other things that are very important, too. Housing statistics, truancy, whatever it is, there are things that our data analyst enables us to do. And we want to take advantage of that. And I think Amy is right. What we'll learn is that maybe a topic that's hot in the committee is very worthy, but when you get it in front of 15 supervisors, they may look at it from a completely different perspective and generate a new idea.
And is the information there? If somebody wanted the monthly statistics on CJCC, isn't it there?
Well, it is, and now we have that updated even a couple times a week. It's on the CJCC website. With the new website, it's a little easier to find. It's always there.
Is it easier to find, Gil?
I haven't tried that one yet. The website is very.
Is the new website up and going?
Yes.
The new website is up and going, and it looks very good. And as with anything that's brand new, kind of like getting those four crates of boxes showing up at your doorstep, we are going through it and learning stuff as we go. It's like, we forgot to do this, or we need to. You know, this has been needs to be updated, but it is up, it's available, and it's much easier and much more appealing. We're gonna get a lot more use of it.
You must have really been struggling.
I must have been really tired or something. I couldn't find it. There isn't anybody that struggles more than I do on that type of a system for us. However, I have one simple question. I could not find the meetings, agendas. I can get the minutes from the last meeting, but I couldn't get the agenda.
Part of the, and believe me, I'm not the expert on this. Everything was designed to do it, but when you transition over, you know, I don't know if the last minutes got transitioned or last agendas got moved over. That's something we're aware of.
I can speak on that just briefly. I touched base with the deputy clerks that have been working on this. All the minutes are there. They're just not put in any particular order. It's sorting them in a random order. So they're there, but it's not like the old system where we can manually sort it. And we're going to reach out to her today and meet with her to find out how we're going to fix
that. I could get the minutes, but I couldn't get the agenda for today.
Yeah. So I was just able to find it here, but it's just not in the right order. So we'll work on making that a little bit easier. But
you said it was at the bottom.
Yeah, it was halfway down. It was down a few pages.
Those are the things.
It wasn't at the top.
Same with the YouTube videos of our meeting. It said, oh, the latest one we had was, you know, of May. Like, that's not right. And I know Claire fiddled with it for a few minutes and go, boom, there it was. So it's just we have to find all those little glitches that we didn't know were there. And we're the nice thing is it is different. You have to think differently than somebody who's used the old one forever. But it once you figure it out, it's most people will go on there for the first time and go, oh, this is easy. I want to go recreate. Where do I see a button? I hit it. If I want to pay my taxes, if I want to go to find out about what's happening in the government or a committee, you click on government, boom, and you can find your committee. So
I was looking to find out where you go if you don't want to be here then.
That would be so
the old term is which way is up. Computer, no, it actually applies to us because we don't know which way is up. But just go up on the computer, go up.
Yeah,
upload it, download it, it's a difference.
Well, I only mentioned that because if someone wants that DJ report monthly, they can get it.
That's correct.
So maybe we, for the next month's agenda too, we can have a little, maybe Claire, go through a little quick little run through of key areas that might be of interest to this committee.
Just to get it so we know how to get the agenda.
Yeah,
on the agenda.
Give it about 3 months and then we'll have a big county board thing to understand the program or any complaints that they can't do. Anybody
we'll do like a scavenger hunt. We'll see which supervisor can go to all these different places.
private tutoring.
I'll be sick that day.
So are we just given the go ahead then?
Yeah. I don't think you need to take any formal credit.
Let's have an update on our status for negotiations with the Polk County Fair Society.
So Mr. Loso and the attorney for the Fair Society had a telephone call about a week and a half ago, and they worked out the issue as far as where we were with drafting. So the Fair Society is meeting with their attorney, and they are creating a list of kind of a wish list of things, and they're going to bring that forward. And so I think what we should do is anticipate receiving that shortly and put a closed session on your next agenda so that we can discuss that. If we do have that in hand, we can always skip it if we don't have that in hand.
Comments from anybody or questions?
Any comments?
Nothing.
Nothing new.
Okay. I mean, I hope we finally get a date, you know. I've encouraged the fair board to, you know.
They have elections. And
they have elections in November.
Yeah. And so, I mean, that's going to be a key factor. So you know what personalities you're getting on the other side.
Yeah, one of the concerns they had was bringing their lawyer all the way up here and paying him to come. You know, I said, well, then
we talked to him and told him we could provide him the Zoom instructions so that he would not. He said he would prefer in person.
Where is he from?
River Falls.
Oh, that's
quite a
drive.
Wow.
That's almost out of the county.
All right. Let's stay with our status. If there's nothing else, how about our committee work plan?
Don't have anything in November on the work plan itself, but I think we've already got a couple items for the next month's meeting.
Yeah, so we'll put the resolution to modify the code of ethics. And then for next meeting, if you want to add, I don't know what we want to label it. It's a new complaint, ethics complaint. It's also a public records request. Claire and I are working on the public records side of it. I did already provide this to Amy, and you also wanted this shared. We're not going to discuss this today. Obviously, it's not on the agenda, but for the next agenda.
I have a question on Wells Riley.
They used to do a lot of work for Polk County, but now they appear to be working on the other side. So this is the same attorney that represents the Blue Rock Quarry applicant for the CUP in front of the Environmental Services that has filed a lawsuit against them.
They filed a lawsuit against us. And now they also represent.
No, they no longer have to do any work representing us. But in the past, they were, they used to do a lot of personnel related employment law work for the county many years ago when I first started.
I remember.
They used to do our insurance. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, we're putting a the closed session on in November or
fair?
Fair. Mm-hmm. And then do we need, is this something we got to deal with?
We should have a closed session in case we want to come to strategy.
For the fair board one?
For the fair board, for this, because this is threatening a lawsuit.
Yep. What would we call that? Potential lawsuit?
I will draft the language for the clerk's office to add to the agenda.
I was just looking for added for
so when I didn't see where we did the MOU updates, we did a few of the big ones for a while. Years ago.
You mean the other MOUs with other?
Yeah, all the MOUs. Because we went to do all of them and we ended up just doing a few of the bigger ones.
I think that you usually do that in December.
Okay.
Is that executive or general government?
I think it's general
government. It's general government, but we threw a few on the executive. Because I remember getting a few for the executive, the trail ones and some other bigger ones. There's what? There's quite a few MOUs and rentals and all that.
Maybe we
create an index.
Maybe there are certain ones that we can discuss. We can put that on December 2nd, just to say going into 2023, here are some other MOUs that we have or have not agreed to.
I might have that. I didn't bring my brief. I think I'll pull that out and see if I have it.
So we'll put that on in December. If there are any MOUs for this committee to review, we'll do them in November.
Yeah. We set through a couple of the trail ones and stuff.
Yeah. All right.
Otherwise, I'll rest with you, general government.
Well, the subject matters for our next meeting. We already have a couple of them.
I don't think
there's any more.
Does the ethics stuff stay around there then?
Well, the ethics
discussion or not?
Yeah, because I'm going to bring the resolution to
okay.
change.
So that one will be there. Okay.
Yep. So that will be on there.
All right. Well, we did general government the other day on like 45 minutes, approaching 35.
Oh, wow.
One item to go.
Okay. It's not for me because I have court and I was going to have Mr. Losa do it by Zoom from the conference. So
Are you ready for a motion? I'll make a motion to adjourn.
All in favor?
Aye.
Damn it, I was going to tell that. No one is more